Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a vehicle that has intake runner solenoid and you need to test it guys because you have problems with the intake runner solenoid. We will explain how to test it and if it checks out fine, what else can go wrong, which can cost you just a few dollars to fix it guys. So stay with us and we'll explain what else to look for if that one checks out fine. If you don't do it right away, you can burn them pretty easily. So make sure you stay until the end. Before we start, okay, let me tell you guys, every single car we get at the garage, we take them completely apart. We show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Another thing, if you guys need to buy any parts, tools for your car for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from for a really good price and quick shipping as well. Now, let's explain how to test that intake runner solenoid. Let's first explain how it works, guys. On most cars, okay, the intake runner solenoids are actually operated by electric signal and by vacuum signal. Now, the vacuum, guys, ours will be installed down here. Okay, you can see like that. And one of the holes, okay, will be the vacuum hose. That's the one that creates vacuum. And that hose will be the one that actually triggers the actuator. That vacuum hose, if you look at it guys, okay, that vacuum hose is connected usually to the intake manifold or the brake booster, and this is the one that we have right here. And you have a one directional valve. The purpose of that valve is to keep the vacuum in that hose, so you constantly have vacuum guys in the system even when the engine is turned off. Now, if that valve checks out fine guys, what I recommend, always check your one directional valve, check hoses, make sure you don't have a vacuum leak. That's number one reason for those things not to work. Number two will be a bad solenoid. But how do you guys test them? Pretty simple. You have two wires. One is positive, one is negative. But you can switch them as long as you don't touch the two wires together while we have a 12 volt supply. Because if you touch them together here, okay, you will burn it and then you will need to replace it for sure. So, with the help of an alligator clips guys, okay, we can actually connect it to a car battery now. And if you need to buy any alligator clips, we'll put the link in the description of the video below where you can purchase some from. They're not very expensive guys, and they make your life much easier, okay, using those things. Because if you don't, okay, you can easily burn that valve, and if it was fine, you will need to replace it anyway. So we'll go ahead, connect the alligator clips, and we'll explain what to do next. So, we'll show you how you can actually switch them on the car battery. You can do them either way, positive or negative. Okay, listen now. Okay, let's switch them now. It opens and closes, we can hear it working. So, listen now. Perfect, it's working. But the fact that it's clicking doesn't mean anything. Why? Because you may have a mechanical problem inside. Electrically it's fine, but mechanically it may not close all the way or it may not open, guys. And that could lead to problems as well. So how do you test that? If you get a balloon, guys, blow it up. Okay, put it on the inlet side where the vacuum is. And when the valve, you don't have a 12 volt supply, it's not activated, it should hold the pressure and not leak anything out of here at all. Okay, nothing. And when you open it, guys, it should leak out of the other hole. Listen now. So when I open it, the balloon deflates. When I close it, it stops. That's a good valve, guys, right here. So that's how you guys test them. It keeps pressure, it closes, it opens, everything's normal. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching. See you next time.